Hello everyone. So today we will discuss the motion of charged particle in an electric field. Now for this, we will consider a charged particle here at point O. Now we will throw this charged particle towards the screen which is placed here. This is the screen over here. This is the screen. So when we will throw this charged particle towards the screen, it will strike the screen at point P. It will strike the screen at point P when there is no electric field. Now after this, we will apply the electric field. Here it is the positive plate. You are seeing that it is the positive plate over here. And here it is the negative plate. So electric field is generated over here. And the direction of electric field is from positive plate towards the negative plate. Now under the effect of this electric field, this charged particle will get deviated from its path. It will move towards the negative plate and it will strike the screen at point Q instead of at point P. So before we will find that when there was no electric field, it strikes the screen at point P. Now when we applied the electric field, it got deviated and it's strikes the screen at point Q, and the distance between P and Q is Y, in the Y direction. So this is what we have written over here. Let the charged particle is thrown from O towards the screen. In the absence of electric field, the charged particle directly strikes the screen at P. In presence of electric field, it will strike at Q. It will get attracted towards the negative charge. Now we will find the motion along the x-axis. We will find the motion along this x-axis. And already as we know, S is equal to ut plus half of at square. Here, the distance S is equal to the x. So place here the x, and the velocity which we give the particle along the x-axis is represented by ux, which is a constant, and the acceleration along the x-axis, let if it will be any, it will be represented by ax. But we know when we give the velocity to this charged particle along x-axis, that is a constant velocity. So if it is a constant velocity, the acceleration produced is equal to the zero. So x is equal to ut plus zero, that means t is equal to x by u. This is the expression for the time period.